I'm Sarah Joyner. I'm the Vice Chair of the MS Trust, and I've been involved since 2007 because I used to be the patron from 2007 till 2012, and doing a great range of different activities with the Trust.
My name is Christine Singleton. I'm a clinical specialist physiotherapist, and I first got involved with the Trust in 1996 as part of my clinical work, because I was dealing with neurological patients and I wanted to know what the MS Trust was doing, and was so impressed with their work that I've been working with them ever since. FES is using electrical stimulation to augment, to add to your own neurological problem. And depending on the condition that you have, in this case we're dealing with multiple sclerosis, there is a pathway problem. You're not getting the messages to tell the foot to lift up. And electrical stimulation adds to that by going straight to the muscles, giving the electrical stimulation to those muscles that lift the foot up. And then we do it in a way functionally, so that with the use of a foot switch, it does it as the patient is walking. So it adds and provides safe walking, which is really important. Neurological patients, there are a few exceptions. So anyone who has a drop foot that doesn't have the contraindications, and you would have to be screened for the contraindications for that. But not only is it useful for neurological patients, but electrical stimulation per se can be used with musculoskeletal problems as well.
The basic principle are the two electrodes that stimulate your femoral nerve. The actual positioning of them, don't worry about that, you will be shown by your physiotherapist, because it may be slightly different for every person. And then there is a long lead that goes into it, red to the front connector and black to the back. And this lead runs all the way up to your battery pack, which is this device here. And it has a 9-volt battery in it, which is either rechargeable or the standard ones that you can buy. And that activates your lead on this side. Then there's a second lead, which we are just getting for you. I wear a wireless setup, so my second lead is like that and is in my shoe. And that has a little wireless pack that goes with it, which is this, and that sends the signal to this box. But more importantly, you need to be able to cover up your electrodes, because otherwise they peel off. And what I found most useful for me, Christine gave me this tip and it's been an absolute lifesaver, you take a pop sock in your skin tone and you cut off the bottom bit. And then you just make a bit of a cut at the top, because you don't want to cut off your blood supply on your leg either. And then you slip it on. Very well, and you run it right up to where those electrodes are. Make sure your leads are all nice and flat and level under there. And there we are, ready to go.
And some people use tuba grip to do exactly the same thing, to cover the electrodes. Or indeed, another tip is to use an old pair of socks, particularly for the men. An old pair of socks, they cut off the foot part of that, and they've got a colour-coded own tuba grip that they can use to cover the electrodes.
Yes. If you're wanting to wear your skinny jeans, what I have found works absolutely brilliantly. Still need to have these covered up, but you move your pop sock down quite a bit. Make sure again you're not cutting off your blood supply. Get your ordinary sock that you might be wearing under your jeans anyway, and get it so that that sock covers the pop sock by a good inch. And then it means you really can get into skinny jeans. And it works. And if you're not wanting to wear the sock because you decide you want to wear pretty flat pumps with your electrics in, you just pull the sock off underneath, from the trousers as you're taking them off.
And the reason for having the tuba grip on under skinny jeans like this, or even normal trousers, is that these are sticky pads and they can stick to the jeans and then move and roll up. And it's important that they stay on the leg, otherwise it won't work.
Because they have to remain in the position that you need to have them to stimulate
your
nerve.
Absolutely, yeah. And then obviously you just connect it to the stimulator, which is the battery pack, as Sarah calls it. And then test that the position of your foot is correct by the stimulation that you're getting, and then obviously put your shoes on and off you go.
Boosted my confidence enormously, because I now feel confident to walk outside, because we all know how treacherous the pavements are in the UK or anywhere else in the world. The confidence has really been tremendous, but I'm now walking distance, so I'm developing stamina. I do come home, I can see why people get into those tracker devices, and I go, oh, I did 5,000 steps today, or I did 3,000 steps, or I say to myself, I need to do a bit more walking tomorrow. So it's actually giving me exercise, and it means for the first time in 30 years, I've been walking in my local park. I've been in there lots of times in my wheelchair scooter, but it is so nice to be walking. It's also holding me more upright.
Absolutely.
My centre of gravity has moved back. It really has been hugely beneficial.
Has it dropped any maybe back pain that you might have had from the way you were walking before?
It has in some ways. In one other way, it's given me a slight more of a twinge, but that's because I'm getting used to
readjustment.
But yeah. No, it has definitely readjusted my hips.
And what about the effort of you lifting up your foot? Has that changed?
Much easier, much easier. And people say to me that I look as if I'm walking with ease.
Yes.
Rather than struggling.
Yes.
And that, it's quite interesting, other people's perceptions about it.
Yeah, absolutely. And also other people's confidence in actually allowing you to go or to be around you while you're doing your walking as well.
Yes.
Because they know that you're safe.
That's right, yes.
Electrical stimulation, or the drop foot stimulator, is provided by a professional, so a clinician, a physiotherapist, or as in the case with Oddstock Medical, they've got clinical engineers down there as well as the physiotherapist.
Yes.
That provide the service. So you need to ask for a referral. You either do that through your GP or your consultant, or even your nurses, if you've got an
yes.
MS nurse, if you have a condition with MS. And then occasionally people can self-refer, particularly if they want to do it privately, and Oddstock Medical do it privately as well. And many of the other clinicians around the country do private service as well. The referral then has to go, obviously, to the centre where you're going to be seen. So depending on where you are in the country, there are certain centres in the country. Oddstock Medical have a franchise in different places, but there's my service in the Midlands, which is completely NHS and separate from Oddstock Medical. And there are other services like my own in the country. We would then find out what funding was required, and that's often can be a stumbling block, depending on what your commissioners are prepared to fund. Again, that depends. Sometimes we have to apply for funding directly to the commissioners, and in other cases like myself, in the service that I run, we have a blanket funding, so we can see patients no matter where they are, certainly within the West Midlands, because we cover the whole of the West Midlands. And then it's a question of having an assessment, because not everybody is suitable for electrical stimulation. So the assessment would be your screening. So at assessment, which is normally about an hour's treatment, you find out whether electrical stimulation is suitable for you, is going to make a difference. And then if it is, there's the process of teaching you how to, future appointments,
yes.
and teaching you how to apply it, and then giving you the support as time goes on. Because it's a technical piece of equipment, it needs to be monitored all the time, mainly because obviously the technology, but also people change, and it's
yes.
important to make adjustments with the stimulator. So you need the support of a clinician all the time going through. And so for some of my patients, I've been seeing them for 15, 16 years now, you know, continually, on an annual basis,
okay.
because essentially the patients or the people with the condition are treating yourself, and you know, the only time between appointments that you need to contact us is if something's gone wrong,
yes.
If you've changed in any way, or if you want any advice or further consumables. That's really the only reason. I'd love a penny for every time, and it happens every single day that I'm told I've made a difference to people's lives, and
yes,
such a positive difference. Mm-hmm. And then not just to their lives, but to their immediate family's lives as well. Because then you get situations, a classic would be that a mother of children would stay at home while the husband, father takes the children out, whereas now they go out with them. So it's that inclusion, which is so
yes,
important, because they feel confident in going out, as Sarah has said, about walking outside.
Yeah.
And that's so important. But no, every single day I get told, you know, what a wonderful job this is, what a wonderful product this is, and makes my life so much easier. You know, you get rewarded every day with comments
and
like that.
It's great to have something that isn't more medicine to take.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
And that, and you can do it yourself.
Yes.
Because,
and it's keeping you fit.
Yes.
You know, the whole effect around it is really quite
yeah,
wonderful.
Yeah. It's your choice whether
yes,
you put it on or not, isn't
that's
it?
Right.
So you're totally in charge of your own treatment, which
yes,
is really lovely, isn't it?
Mm.
It's to have that power.